Yes, so it's going to be a quick report of the project we started this year on the biocontrol of fruit fly using a biocontrol agent, the parasitoids Hymenoptera. So this is conducted with Pierre Addison and a MSc student, Bianca Stitt. So fruit flies is a big problem in, well, on a world scale and especially in Africa. Several species, big damage, difficult access to market through export due to regulation, as many species are a quarantine pest. So the parasitoids are Hymenoptera parasitoids are little wasps that lay eggs, their eggs in the eggs of the fly or in the larvae, and by developing in the larvae they kill the pest. So parasitoids, they will never destroy all the population of fruit flies in an orchard, but they contribute to lower the level of population in the natural lands nearby the orchard and avoid a continuous spillover of pests in the orchard. So that's what is interesting to look at them. But the problem with in South Africa, we don't really know what species are there, where they are distributed, what fruit fly they prefer, what fruit they prefer. Maybe they parasitize fruit flies in some fruit and not in others. And so the idea of this project was to get an overview of the parasitoid available there to potentially set up some augmentoria system. So augmentoria is basically you put the fallen fruits with fruit flies in a box with a mesh, and the fruit fly can't escape, but the parasitoid, yes, they do, so they can emerge and parasitize other fruit flies and low down population. So we sampled mainly fruits in the Western Cape, and also in we receive samples from the Mpumalanga and Limpopo regions. About 20 fruit cans were sampled, including grown fruits, sorry, also and also non-grown fruit, natural fruits. We incubated the fruits in box and tracked for the emergence of the fruit fly species and parasitoids and identified them. So these are the parasitoids we obtained in total. So down there are the Aphanteles is a parasitoid of false codling moss. So we got them through the emergence, but it's not directly a parasitoid of fruit flies. The two others, Aganaspis and Azobara, we don't really know. From the literature, apparently, it could parasitize fruit fly, but it's mostly parasitoid of drosophiles that can also develop in the fruits. But the main fruit fly parasitoids of the three species, Tetrasticus, Phocus, and Psittalia. For strange reason, we don't know why, we found only parasitoids involved in biocontrol, well, but have been already reared as a biocontrol agent in the northern eastern part of the country. We don't know why we didn't get any in the Western Cape, maybe due to climate difference, or maybe because the flies colonized this region more recently and the parasitoid couldn't follow it yet. So this was an unexpected but interesting result to look at and to think about potential future introduction of biocontrol agent. These are like preliminary results of the parasitism rate of the fruit flies in different fruit kinds. So you can see that in some, so these are white fruits, but in some white fruit you can get up to 60% of population control of this fruit fly by the parasitoids. But there is obviously a big difference. And for example, some mango we tested, there was only 4%. So we are currently analyzing this data to know if there is a link between a fruit kind and fruit size for the parasitism of the fly. You see the parasitoids, they've got an ovipositor to reach the larvae. So maybe big fruits are difficult, and there's a problem of accessibility of the larvae. So that is under investigation. So for the next steps, try to investigate in more detail what's the origin of this difference in distribution. We are sampling actually parasitoids from different regions in all Africa and other districts in South Africa to see those different cryptic species that are adapted to specific environment or fruit fly species. So we are sequencing specimens from fresh material and museum as well to cover more samples. And also in the fruit, you've got several fruit flies. So when the parasitoids emerge, you don't know exactly what parasitoid feed on what fruit fly. So we are using metabarcoding to reconstruct the trophic network and see who parasitizes who. Thank you for your attention.